Oh, in basketball, we see that because there's a lot of running and jumping and landing and cutting, that there's some very high forces in the ligaments. And we see this especially in women's basketball. And oftentimes these lead to ACL injuries in this particular sport. For some reason, women are more susceptible to getting ACL injuries than men are. There's a lot of factors involved in that. Could be because that there are hormonal differences in women, and we know that hormones can affect the stress strain properties of the tissues. There is a difference in the geometry of the hips of women, which the pelvis is larger and it makes the forces through the knee go at a slightly different angle, and that can affect the way the ACL gets torn. Fundamentally, a lot of it has to do with the way the muscles are used to stabilize the joint. If you use your muscles properly and you can hold the joint together with the muscles, then you can take a lot of the loads off the ligaments. It's only when things are caught unexpectedly, then the muscles don't have a chance to react, that the force gets borne by the ligaments, and then that causes them to rupture. We have people walk and run and cut in the laboratory because we want to take a look at what forces are going through the knee during different types of activities of daily living. We do this in healthy people and people who have had ACL injuries. And we're interested in taking the data from the gait lab, and from that we put it into a model that allows us to estimate forces in the muscles and the tendons and the ligaments and the cartilage. And we can see what happens as those forces get translated into the human body. What we've found is that during cutting tasks especially, the forces are very high in the ligaments, which is what leads to ACL injuries.